Hey everyone, it's Chris again. I've been out filming a few different videos today, and I thought while I'm out here, I'd try and, apart from all the crazy fun stuff, thought I'd try and do a bit more of a informative bit of video, covering reloading, good techniques and practices when it comes to M4, M16, all those similar sort of weapons. So you've got your SCAR-L, your HK416, various different rifles that this sort of thing applies with. Now, I'm going to be using my GBB gas blowback M4, so this is going to be a bit more in-depth and involved than what you'd need with an AEG. When it comes to an AEG, obviously it's just mag out, fresh mag in. You don't need to be worrying about bolts and bolt releases and all that sort of stuff. But yeah, this is going to be probably a bit more sort of close to what you're doing with the real thing. Now, the way I do things, it's not specific. I don't copy anyone in particular. This is just a combination of what I've learned in the military, what I've learned through airsofting, watching various sort of training DVDs. I've watched the Magpul ones, Larry Vickers, different guys like that, and I've just sort of tried to make it all fit to me. So this is what works for me, and I tend to find it's fairly efficient. So yeah, like I say, gas blowback M4, pretty similar in operation to a real thing in terms of the way the bolt works. You've got your bolt release there, lets the working parts go forward and it locks it to the rear. Forward assist does function, although realistically you shouldn't ever need it. I don't think it would ever be of any use on one of these. If you did get some sort of a stoppage, it's not really going to be the bolt carrier not going all the way forward. That shouldn't really be happening. If it is, then you've probably got some issue with the magazine's not seeking that. But yeah, with these, the first thing you need to do before you come to loading it, so you've got your guns totally empty, no BB in the chamber, no magazine, not cocked, anything like that. First thing when it comes to the initial load is you've got to rack and cock it, because the actual striker that hits the gas valve on the magazine needs to be withdrawn back into the working parts of the gun, otherwise it's going to make it difficult to insert a magazine. So you've cocked it. Next thing, apply a safety catch because it is cocked. Safety first. Grab your first magazine. Now, when grabbing the magazine, make sure you get as far down the grip as it on the actual magazine itself as you can. Try and get your finger so it's kind of like that, or get high up grip on the magazine, because that makes it a lot easier to insert into the magwell or the mag housing. So yeah, weapon's cocked. Now, magazine in. Make sure, don't slap it, because you'll probably break something. Just hold it firmly and push. It's all the way in, then you'll know. So that's it, you're ready for action. You know now that you're not quite ready, should we say. There isn't one in the chamber. So you know there's mags in, the actual cock, your safety's on. Next thing is to grab the charging handle again. Now, because it's empty at the moment, obviously it's locked back. But if you had BBs in there, it would go forward again. So you simulate that, or sled forward again. At that point, you know you have a BB in the chamber. I'm not putting BBs in right now just because I'm not planning on shooting and it's safer not to have actual ammo in the gun. So yeah, that is, you're ready, and you know the entire time you've been doing that, the safety's been on because you cocked it before you put the magazine in, so there's no chance that you could fire this off accidentally and fire off a BB any time during that operation. So that's your weapon loaded, you've gone into the game. And then, Marshall's blowing the whistle, game started. You take your safety off, for the sake of argument, I'll put it on semi-auto. And then you trot around, you go in the game. You're firing away, firing. Bam, magazine's empty. Now, what you'll notice, first thing I did there, spin the rifle over to the left. Straight away, as soon as you feel that squeeze on the trigger, nothing happening, spin it over to the left, get it, bam, right over there. Common mistake people make is they'll sort of go, don't do that, just whip it over. Should take less than a second. What you want to be looking for is inside the chamber, see if there's any BBs in there, and inside the top of the magazine, see what's in there. Now technically, of course, it could be a stoppage. It might not just be that the magazine's empty. You can get double feeds and misfeeds and various other problems with your gas blowback gun. So you want to be looking inside that area, see what's going on, see what position the bolt is. Is it all the way locked to the rear as it should be? Is it part way stuck? Is it forward? What's going on? But for now, we won't talk about stoppages, just reload. So in this situation, you can see there's no BBs in the chamber, there's no rounds in the mag, and the bolt working parts is locked fully to the rear. That means empty magazine, of course. So you've whipped it over, you've looked, you've seen, no rounds left. Straight away, over to the right. Now, at that point, your finger is going to be going up towards the mag release. Left hand comes up, press out, keeping the weapon at all times up. That way, very common mistake. People, they're down here doing reloads like this, and you know, some guy's over there, he pops up, bam, bam, takes you out. You should be weapon up. Obviously, if you're in front of some cover, drop down, take cover while you're reloading. But that's optional. You know, it depends. If there's no threat out there and you think you can reload fast enough, then you just stay up. So, magazines come out. Put that away, either back in your pouch or in a dump pouch or your pocket, whatever you're going to do with it. Next thing, get to that next magazine, get that nice low grip on it so you can get it straight into the magwell. None of this kind of fussing about, you know, missing the magwell and stuff. Nice high grip, so it goes straight into the magwell like that. So you've got your mag in. Now then, once you're there, keep that left hand up on the magazine. That way you can go straight to the bolt release. So you've inserted, as you're hitting the bolt release, bring it back into the shoulder, and bam. You know, there's a round back in the chamber again. As soon as you hit that bolt release and the bolt's gone back forward, you're back in the firing position. You've got a round back in the chamber, fresh mag for the BBs, the bolt's forward, you're cocked, safety's off. As soon as you pull that trigger, it's gonna fire. So go through that one more time, a little bit quicker. So playing your game, come along, fighting away. Next thing you know, bang, magazine's empty. Switch it over to the left. Come up, finger onto the mag release, empty magazine comes out, stow it away wherever you're gonna stow it. Next magazine, nice strong grip, as low down as you can on the mag, into the magwell, firm up there. Again, really emphasizing keeping that look, keeping your eyes up, watching whatever's going on. So that fresh mag's in. As you're coming round, hit the bolt release, back into the shoulder, hand back in your firing position, and you're firing again. You can do that, you know, with practice. If you've got your, you know, if you're running some nice, say, shingle pouches or overtop pouches, maybe you run a dump pouch, you can get that, you can do that whole thing fairly quick. Some people dump their mags on the floor. I wouldn't recommend that with a gas weapon because these things are heavy and fragile. But say you're running an AEG and you just got some cheap Chinese plastic mid caps, because they're so light, it's not really going to matter if you throw them on the floor. So just trying to simulate that. Firing away. Bang, bang, bang. Magazine's empty. Straight into firing. That's how quick it can be done. I mean, I didn't time that just then, but by dropping that mag on the floor, probably less than 2 seconds. It's pretty quick. Whereas, you know, you often see guys running cheap vests and they've got buckles and Velcro and blah blah blah, and it takes them absolute ages, and they drop down and it takes about 5 minutes buffing around trying to get the new mag. They take that and trying to stick it back in a pouch that they've also got to open, get that one in, open up another one with buckle and a Velcro and all sorts of other stuff, and eventually they get that out, and then they fumble around and miss a few times and eventually get it in, and then they're back in, and it takes forever. So a few simple rules, guys, just stick to that, and you can really get that time down, and you're not wasting time being out of the fight with no ammo in your gun. So yeah, hope that's useful for you guys. Anyone's got any feedback, any questions, make sure to post them in the comments. Hopefully that was helpful, as I say. See you next time.